Alrighty guys, today I'm going to be showing you how I prepare beans for the freezer. When anytime I work in the kitchen, I find it absolutely imperative to pour one glass of wine into the cook. Of course, you want to begin by washing your beans. I like to add a quarter to a half a cup of white vinegar. This helps to clean the beans a little bit better, and it acts as a mild antibacterial agent. Swish it around real good, get the vinegar mixed in together, and allow the beans to sit for about 10 minutes. After about 10 minutes, then rinse it real good with fresh water and drain. Next, we want to snap the ends off the beans and remove the fibrous strings from the sides of it. Just snap the beans, not all the way through, but just snap and then pull the end down the side, and you'll see the string coming off. And then you'll want to grab the other end, spin it around, and do the same thing and remove the fibrous tissue from the other side. You'll notice that the more mature the bean is, the stronger and the bigger the fibrous tissue is. The younger beans and smaller ones don't seem to have such a bad problem with the string. At this point, you can decide to either freeze them whole, or as I do, I like to break them down into approximately 2.5 to 3 inch pieces. Now, let's prepare the water for blanching. I'm going to put approximately 1 tablespoon of salt in the water. This pot is about 10 inches tall and about 10 inches across, and it's filled with about three quarters of the way up with water. I am now also going to put about 1/4 cup to 1/2 cup of vinegar in there. Once again, this acts as a mild antibacterial to help kill any other bacteria that may be on the beans. Will also help with cleanup with the pot later on as well. And now we want to get the top on and bring it to a full rolling boil. Once the water has come to a full rolling boil, get your beans in. I don't like to stuff them completely in there. I like to have them loose enough so that the beans will roll freely with the boil of the water. You want them to boil for approximately 2 minutes once it comes back to a full rolling boil. Notice also that there is a pan to the left full of ice water that is there to immediately pour the beans in to stop the cooking process. The beans have been rolling in the boil for 2 minutes, and now I want to take them and put them in the bowl of cold water to quickly cool them down in order to stop the cooking process. Just because they're being taken out of the boiling water doesn't mean they stop cooking. The heat within the beans will continue to cook them. I only want them blanched, not cooked all the way through. Okay, the ice water is now hot water, and the beans are not cool enough, so I am going to rinse them in cool water, and I'll do this 2 or 3 times or until I am satisfied that they are cool enough. As you can see, I have chosen to use freezer bags to store my beans in the freezer. The reason for this is that I can put as many beans in there as I feel that my wife, myself, and my daughter are going to eat with one meal. That way I don't have to take 2 containers out and then have possibly have leftovers, or 1 container and not be enough. So I really like the freezer bag method. I'll put them in there, shake them down real good, and then squeeze as much of the air out as possible. Now at this point, if you have access into a vacuum sealer machine, that would be excellent. But I don't have access to one, so I am just going to be squeezing as much of the air out as possible and twisting the bag several times and bending it over, and then using a rubber band to tightly seal it. Well, I hope this video has helped you. If it has, I would appreciate it if you would leave a comment and let me know. If you have other information that could be helpful to me, I would surely appreciate it if you would leave a comment as well. Well, you folks have a good day. Thanks for watching. Bye.